Puffy or Casper, which mattress should you choose? Hey guys, it's Martin here from Mattress Clarity, and today I'm talking about just that. I'm gonna talk about both these mattresses, their construction, their similarities, their differences, and help you choose one over the other. Let's get started. First off, you want to see a list of our top picks for mattresses, head over to mattressclarity.com. There you're going to find some great reviews on mattresses, bedding, pillows, and great discounts on mattresses like the Puffy and the Casper. So let's start off by talking about the similarities between these two mattresses. First, they are both very popular bed-in-a-box mattresses. They both have very good customer service terms. They have a very similar base layer in their construction. They both are very similar in terms of firmness, and they're similar in terms of price. Now let's talk about the differences between these two mattresses. First off, the Casper Original mattress is going to be thicker than the Puffy mattress. Also, the Casper is going to have a zoned construction. The Puffy mattress does not. There are also going to be some other materials differences, namely in the top layer. So on top of the Puffy, more of a slow-moving memory foam. On top of the Casper, more of a bouncy, responsive poly foam. Because of that, different feels between these two mattresses. Both overall have a balanced foam feel, but right on top of the Puffy mattress, a little bit more of that slow-moving memory foam feel. So now let's take a look at the construction of both these mattresses, starting on top and then working our way down. First off, speaking of the cover on the Casper mattress, a knit cover, very thin, very breathable. Over on the Puffy, also thin, breathable, won't affect the overall feel of these mattresses too much. Now moving down to the comfort layers on the Casper mattress right on top, a layer of soft poly foam that's also quite responsive. It also features something called airscape technology. Basically, it's ventilated for airflow. And below that, you have a layer of memory foam, but this layer is zoned. It's the zone support system in the Casper mattress. Basically, it's firmer towards the center of the mattress, softer towards the head and the foot. So when you're back sleeping and stomach sleeping, it's firmer, more supportive. When you're side sleeping, it's more pressure relieving. Moving over to the Puffy mattress, on top, a layer of slow-moving memory foam, also has a gel infusion to help with cooling. Below that, a firmer transition layer, it's also more responsive, adds some bounce to the top of the mattress. Last but not least, speaking of the support layers on both mattresses, a base support foam. So what does all that mean? Well, first off, the main difference between these two mattresses is going to be that zone support system you find in the Casper, but not in the Puffy. So again, the Casper is going to feel different depending on your sleeping position, with the Puffy more of a uniform feel no matter what position you're sleeping in. Now, speaking of breathability and cooling, it's going to be close between these two mattresses. They're both all foam mattresses, so they are going to trap some heat. That being said, they both have some cooling components. So on top of the Casper mattress, the airscape technology, ventilated for airflow. Over with the Puffy mattress, also a breathable cover, and the top layer is going to have some gel infusion to help with cooling and some cooling components in the second layer as well. And lastly, speaking of durability, probably going to be close between these two mattresses. They both have some high density foams, but they're all foam mattresses. Looking at their construction, their material should last for around 7 to 10 years. So now let's talk about firmness and feel. In terms of firmness, I thought both mattresses were close to a 7 out of 10, just a little bit firmer than average. I do want to note though, it's going to be a little bit different between these two mattresses because of that zone support system. So with the Casper, it's going to feel a little bit firmer, more supportive, depending on your sleeping position. Over the Puffy, you're not going to have that same experience. Also, I'm 250 pounds. If you are lighter than me, you might not press in quite so far into both these mattresses. They might feel softer to you than they did to me. On the other hand, if you're larger than me, you might press in further. They might feel firmer to you than they did to me. But for me, a 7 out of 10 for both mattresses. Now, in terms of feel, they are quite close. They both have more of an overall balanced foam feel, responsive, make it easy to move around on both mattresses. That being said, you get a little bit more of that slow-moving memory foam feel right on top of the Puffy. You don't get that feel on top of the Casper. And now let's talk about how I feel in different sleeping positions on both these mattresses. Starting off on the Casper on my back, a very good match for me. With that zone support, extra lumbar support, my hips sink in the right amount, a little bit of contouring as well, and good overall support. Moving to my side, I am feeling some pressure on my shoulders and my hips, but not too much. Again, if you weigh less than me, you might not press in quite so far. You could feel better pressure relief than I did. Moving to my stomach, my hips are bowing in just a little bit, but I'm feeling a little bit of support also from that zone support system. Again, if you're lighter than me, light or medium weight, you should feel better support than I did in this position. Moving over to the Puffy mattress on my back, also a pretty good match for me, a good balance of comfort and support. Hip sinking the top foam layer, not too far, good lumbar support, good contouring as well. Moving to my side, I'm feeling more pressure on my shoulders and my hips than I felt over on the Casper. Again, if you're light or medium weight, you would feel better pressure relief than I did. Moving to my stomach though, not quite supportive enough for me. I'm not getting quite as much support as I felt over on the Casper. Here at Mattress Clarity, we like to mix subjective opinion with objective tests. And one of those tests is the pressure map. So I lie down on my backside and stomach. You see anywhere from blue for no pressure all the way up to red for high pressure. Now let's pull up the side-saving results for both these mattresses. And looking at these results, pay close attention to my shoulders and my hips. If you sleep with the partners, two other things you do want to think about. That's motion transfer and edge support. Now motion transfer means you're lying down on one side of the mattress and your partner moves around on the other side. Are you going to feel that motion or not? Now edge support means you're sitting or lying down at the edge of a mattress. Do you feel secure or like you're going to roll off and onto the floor? Now, speaking of motion transfer, I would give the advantage to the Puffy mattress. That's because it has slow-moving memory foam right on top, absorbing a lot of that motion, so less motion transfer on the Puffy mattress. Speaking of edge support, I would give the advantage to the Casper mattress. I personally feel more secure sitting and lying down at the edge of the Casper. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Which one of these mattresses should you get? In terms of who should get the Casper, I think it's the better option for combo sleepers. That's because that zone support system gives you more support when you're back and stomach sleeping and more pressure relief when you're side sleeping. It's also the better option for back sleepers who need more lumbar support. With that zone support system, it really presses up into your lumbar area, gives you nice support there. Also, those who prefer something a little bit bouncier, a little bit more responsive, you definitely get that with the Casper. The top layer of responsive polyfoam has some nice bounce to it, makes it very easy to move around on this mattress. Now, in terms of who should get the Puffy, I think it's the better option for light and medium weight side sleepers. Because you had that slow moving memory foam right on top, if you're not too heavy, you won't press in too far, should feel nice pressure relief on your shoulders and your hips. It's also a good option, I think, for back sleepers who don't need as much lumbar support, still has a very good balance of comfort and support on the Puffy. Also in terms of feel, those who like a balanced foam feel overall with a little bit of memory foam feel should like the feel of the Puffy. The Casper and Puffy are both bed-in-a-box mattresses. They're gonna come to your house in a cardboard box. So how do you unbox them? Well, it's super easy. First off, ask a friend for help taking the box inside your house. These boxes can be quite heavy, you don't wanna strain yourself. Then bring the box into your bedroom, open up the top, and take out your rolled up mattress. Place this on your frame or foundation and slowly, carefully cut through the layers of plastic. You don't want to damage your brand new mattress. Then give the mattress about 24 to 48 hours to completely expand, and you're good to go. And now I'd like to answer some frequently asked questions about the Casper and Puffy mattresses. The first question is, which is better, the Casper or the Puffy? I wouldn't say one mattress is better than the other. They're definitely better matched for different types of people, however. So I think if you want more lumbar support, I think you're a combo sleeper, you want more of a balanced foam feel overall, take a look at the Casper. If you like a little bit of a slow-moving memory foam feel, you're a light or medium weight side sleeper, you're a back sleeper who doesn't need quite as much lumbar support, the Puffy should work better for you. The second question is, how long will the Casper and Puffy mattresses last? Well, they're both all foam mattresses, some nice high density foams in their construction, probably gonna last for between 7 and 10 years. Last question is, which mattress is better for side sleepers? They could both be a good option for side sleepers. The Casper has its own construction, so it's softer under the shoulder area. With the Puffy, you have a slow moving memory foam feel right on top, offering good pressure relief, specifically for light and medium weight side sleepers. At this point, you should know which mattress is right for you. But if you're still a bit confused, you want a personal recommendation, just leave a comment below. Well, that's about it. Just getting started looking for a mattress or bedding, head over to mattressclarity.com. We also do a lot of videos just like this, so hit the like button and subscribe.